Now, fellas, Pete from Pete's Tools, awesome to see you here again. I was talking to a couple of you guys the other day, and you were wondering what plasma cutter to buy when you're just starting out. You know, plasma cutters for beginners, and the best plasma cutter to get, and that sort of thing. So I thought I'd do a quick video and let you know what I've learned over the years. Not that you want to take too much note of a silly old git like me, but anyway. Yeah, you might find some useful info in it, and let me know what you think. Always remember to subscribe to my channel if you like what I'm talking about, and drop me a note and say hi. And if you have any issues with your plasma cutter and that, I'll be happy to try and sort it out for you. But there's a bit of a minefield when you first start buying these things, and it's just best to know what you need and what to look for when you start, and you won't have any issues. Anyway, guys, without any further bullshit from me, let's have a look at the video. So the first thing that you need to know is what sort of steel you'll be cutting. I mean, I made this mistake when I bought my first plasma cutter. Are you going to be cutting like rusty steel? Are you going to be cutting steel that's been painted? Or are you going to be cutting new steel? Or are you going to be cutting like thick steel or thin steel? Because there's a difference in the difference in the machine and what you need. But what my advice to you would be, if you're just starting out and you just want a general cut anything sort of thing and just have a play, I would just go for a normal basic machine, because you don't need anything flash when you just start anyway, because you're learning as you go along and all the rest of it. And another big thing, guys, is your consumables. What's your consumable price? Because these are consumables and they cost money to run. And so if I was just starting out, I would just use the cheapest consumables I could find, the easiest to find, the cheapest consumables. So it doesn't matter how many times you bugger it up, you know, you just whack another consumable in and away you go again. So that would be my thoughts on the subject anyway. And there's also, if you're going to cut majority of this sort of steel with paint and that on it, what you need is you need a pilot arc plasma cutter. See, and a lot of the, well, not even a lot of them now, but some of them that you buy, the cheaper ones, are HF, which is high frequency, and others are pilot arc. So if you want to know the difference, and I would suggest you really watch this video, because I've done an in-depth video on the difference, click up the top there now, and I'll put a link to that video, and it'll just help you while you decide to buy whatever you want to buy, because the last thing you want to do is spend money that you don't have to spend to buy something that you don't really want. That's just silly as far as I'm concerned. And I don't know if you've watched many of my videos before, but you know I like a bargain. Some people say I like a bargain, other people say I'm cheap. But you can call me whatever you like, guys. It doesn't bother me at all. I've got thick skin, thick as an elephant, so it doesn't bother me whatsoever. Anyway, guys, so this is it. Look what sort of steel you're cutting, whether you're going to be cutting painted steel, whether you're going to be cutting rusty steel, thick steel, thin steel. But I would suggest that you start with a plasma cutter that can cut something in the order of up to 3/4 inch thick, and that'll just give you a general idea of what you can do. And it sort of, you know, most people don't really want to go any more than 3/4 inch. I wouldn't imagine so anyway. Or I didn't anyway when I first started. In fact, I don't even now when I'm doing it all the time. I mainly cut 3 or 4 millimeter plate. So now, guys, the plasma cutters that I'm talking about are like the ones you find on Amazon or you can get Home Depot or whatever you like, you know. They're cheap, they're good, they're cheap. And most of them have this sort of torch or a variety of this sort of torch. This is like an AG60 torch. Or they'll have a torch something like this, which is a PT31 torch. Or they have the AG60 again, which is the same as this torch. It's just a different version of it. But when you're buying your machine, guys, if you're like me and cheap, like I said it, cheap, then I would go for the one that's the cheapest to run, because these are all different prices to run. Not that there's a huge difference in the price to get your consumables, but when you're only doing it every now and then and you want to save a little bit of money, I like the cheaper consumables, and I like to get value for money. So anyway, that's just how I look at it. So these are some of the torches that you'll get on the thing. A lot of these torches are interchangeable. As long as you interchange a high-frequency machine with a high-frequency torch and an HF torch with a HF machine, then you won't have any bother. So, anyway, let's carry on. Now, this is the machine that I've... This is about my third or fourth machine, I suppose, that I've brought. And I've always stuck with a high-frequency machine. I just prefer it to pilot arc. But, like I say, it just depends what you're cutting, because I was cutting mainly new steel and all the rest of it. Like it says, it's just a cut 40... just a generic Chinese machine. There's a lot of cut 50s out now. I would if I was to buy it again, I'd probably go for a cut 50. It just gives you a little bit more amperage. So you can turn the amperage up from virtually zero right up to 40 amps, or if you've got a cut 50 right up to 50 amps. And at 50 amps, you can cut 3/4 of an inch plate steel. It's a little, might be a little bit slow, but it cuts fine. And this sort of machine here, you're gonna need quite a reasonable size compressor to run it. I would say at least a 20 gallon compressor that you're gonna have to have. You can buy these machines with a compressor already built in, but I have really strong thoughts on that. Click the link up the top there at the top that you'll see flying in there in the minute. And yeah, check out that video because that'll give you all the pros and cons about buying one of these with a compressor already built in. I think you're far better off to buy a separate compressor, and not only do you get more power out of your machine, you'll also be able to use your compressor for spray painting or nail gunning if you've got a nail gun, or artwork if you do airbrushing or something like that. So anyway, like I said, this is just a basic machine. It's just your lead goes in here for your torch, and this is just a 2-wire pin here. Most of these machines are exactly the same. It's just 2 pins there. That's just for the switch on your torch. And then we have this one here for your earth lead. So I'll show you the other end of it. So like I said, well, this here is for your torch. This is a PT31 torch. This torch here runs about the cheapest consumables that I could find. I used to cut sheets and sheets and sheets of 3 and 4 millimeter plate. I used to do it for a living, basically. So I wanted to find the cheapest consumables that I could find for my plasma cutter. So I actually changed this to a PT31 torch to get the cheapest consumables. Click up the top there, guys. There's another video I made up the top there on cheap PT31 consumables and how to change your torch out. So if you have a look at that, that might save you some cash as well. And this here, of course, is just your earth. Just clips in there, pull it out, pull it in. This is just your earth. And this, of course, this is the other end of it here. You bear in mind, this is for you guys that are new to this game. So that's quite good. You just put that onto your steel, whatever you're cutting. And then when you get your torch and your torch touches the steel, meaning this is a HF machine, a high frequency machine, when your torch touches the steel, then it creates a circuit, and then the flame comes out of here and starts cutting. Whereas a pilot arc, if you're cutting like rusty metal, or you're cutting steel with paint on it, then you won't get a very good contact when you touch your steel. So you need the flame to come out of here first so it burns through the paint so you can start cutting. So like I say, that is a pilot arc torch, but I had that video at the top there that I hope you guys have already went and had a look at. And then you know the gritty of it now, cutting up some steel. I love cutting up steel. I like making sparks, making a lot of noise, and that's might just be a boy thing, I don't know. But anyway, I've got my earth clamp here, I've got my machine running in the background that you can hear hissing and whirring and burring there. So we put the earth clamp on your piece of steel that you're cutting. Now this is not too rusty, it's not brand new, but it's not too rusty. This torch should handle it alright. We've got the machine set on about 35 amps, and we'll see what happens, eh? Like a hot knife through butter, guys, and this is using the PT31 torch. Like I say, this is the cheapest consumable for this torch. Brilliant, brilliant little torch. And the advantage of this torch over something like this, I would always go for this torch personally, but the advantage over something like this is, I'll show you with another torch here, it's exactly the same. You pull this off like that, and you look at the consumables, the tip is just your standard tip. But if you look at the electrode is double-ended, meaning when you burn out one, you just flip it over and you get 2 for the price of 1. And they're really, really cheap. They're brilliant. Good for beginner plasma cutter people. Brilliant, I think they are anyway. So like I say, you just turn them over and you keep on going. Whereas if you're using a torch like a AG60 like this, I mean, this is a good torch as well, don't get me wrong. The consumables are probably 40% more expensive. You got your cutting tip here, which is a bit more complicatedly made by the look of it. And then you got your electrode here. Notice the difference in this electrode, guys. You can only get one use out of this electrode. You cannot turn it over. A little bit more complicated torch. So when you go to when you run over your torch, or you stand on it like I do, like a clumsy old git like I am, then you go to replace your torch. This is going to cost you, to replace this torch, it probably cost you 20-25% more than what it would to replace this torch. And so anyway, like I say, I'm a Mr. Cheapo, so I'll sit for the PT31 consumables any day of the week. But anyway, you guys might have different ideas, but that's just my thoughts. Anyway, so what I'll show you now is we've got my trusty torch here, and we've got a piece of thicker steel here. What would that be? That would be, oh, I don't know, it wouldn't be half inch. It would be, oh, I don't know what it might be. But anyway, you can see how thick that is there. But it's painted. So I'll show you the difference. So we'll take our clamp off here, and we'll put them on here, and then we'll try and cut this. See, we're having issues here. That's because it's painted surface. Now, if this was a pilot arc machine, your flame would already come out of there, you'd push the button, you'd burn a hole through it, and you'd just whack. Pilot arc are a little bit more expensive than my machine, like the HF, but they're not that much more expensive. So if you're cutting dirty steel and that, you'd probably be better to go with a pilot arc machine. But anyway, I'll show you how to cut this steel with this torch. Right, so that didn't cut like that. What you need to do is get an angle grinder. That end where you're starting to cut. That end where you're putting your earth plate. Turn that off, and then I'll show you again, show you the difference. So here we go, let's try it again. I've done that for the earth, so we get a good earth on there now. I've taken the paint off the top so I can start the machine, and then we'll see if this works. See that, guys? Not a problemo. She just cuts it like there's no tomorrow. And I'll show you another trick. If you've got a piece here and you've cleaned it off so it hasn't got paint on it, then you can actually cut through paint as well. You watch, I'll show you. See that? We've cut right through that with that paint. But, yeah, so once you get it started, you can cut through the paint, or you can cut through the rust or the other crap that's on your steel, no worries at all. It's just getting it started. So anyway, so that's my thoughts, and I honestly don't think when you're starting out that you need anything flash or big or flash or expensive. I would just stick with a cheap 50 amp plasma cutter. Either decide whether you want to go HF or pilot arc, because that's the main decision, and just make sure it's running cheap consumables, because if you get a torch that runs really expensive consumables, it can be expensive to plasma cut. Whereas these are cheapest chips. It doesn't matter if you break a few or whatever. It doesn't make any difference at all, you know what I mean? But once again, like I say, I'm a cheap ass, so there you go. Anyway, guys, I hope you learned something. Oh, and before I go, also, these torches here, you can get little guide wheels and that for them, and you can cut out shapes and all the rest of it, and you don't have to do it freehand. They're a pretty awesome little thing. Check out the top earlier once again, and I've got another video about that. But if you guys want to know anything, hey, don't be shy. Drop a note down in the comments. I'd love to have a chat with you if you're having issues with it, or you want some advice. Because I'm really into plasma cutter stuff. I enjoy it. You know, it makes me happy, so there you go. Hey, everything's got to make someone happy, doesn't it? So like I say, guys, if you like my videos, subscribe down below. Drop me a note in the comments. And you guys have a great day, eh?